Alrighty, and welcome to the start of another original oil painting that will be developed through a number of virtual painting sessions. So just like always, we're going to be working on, well, I shouldn't say always, but just like most of the time, we're going to be working on a panel. This is an 11 by 14 inch panel. I have my usual colors here. I have changed the palette. Actually, last time I changed the background of the palette, so hopefully it's easier to see. Today we're going to be doing the umber layer slash underpainting. So I'm just going to be using raw umber and flake white, possibly going to use a little bit of alkyd paint in the mix with the flake white just so things dry very quickly. Hey Bruno, Julie Diana 1, Peanut Butter, I like your username. Julie Diana 1, Neldia, again Peanut Butter, Ingrid Carlson, Jerry Robertson, I hope that you're all doing well. This panel was actually toned a couple hours ago, so it's still going to be a tad bit. It may subtract down to the gesso a little bit, but I have this listed in the description box as my favorite panel to work on. This is the one I recommend to all my students. This is a gesso board. I don't know if you can read it back here, if it even picks up, but it's ampersand gesso board museum series. I like it so much that I actually don't add any extra gesso to the board. All I do is oil tone it, and it's pretty much ready to go. Hey Monique, Brian Ross. Monique, by the way, your painting will be ready soon, and I have the photograph for you. I will be sending you the photograph very soon. So everyone, what I'm going to do is introduce a slightly different concept to the way that these streams are going. So for instance, if anyone is noticing here, there is the, well, at least the text for my online classes, patreon.com/upariartist. You can find the online classes for $10 a month here. If you just copy and paste this onto your browser, you should be able to find it. Another thing is I will be running specials and sales for each one of these streams. This one is not going to be for sale though, for at least for the last session for this one. So let me show you in the beginning, and then maybe in the middle, then in the end, the sale that I have for the duration of this stream. And it involves this painting. So this is one of my previous paintings. This one is going to be a special. You see the price there. The special includes a free, a bonus study painting. A bonus study painting is a painting that is created on a sheet of cotton canvas. So it's not going to be this one, but it's going to be something like this that you'll receive whenever you purchase a painting during a live stream. And Monique, you will be receiving one, no worries. So again, here is the painting itself that is for the special sale in the duration of this stream. So that is that. Now let's go ahead and start painting, shall we? So the link for that again is in the description box, and I'll be posting the link for that periodically. So for example, here is the link for you. Hopefully it works. Again, the link is in the description box down below, but also here is the link itself. Actually, never mind, YouTube's not letting me post the link. Just check out the description box and it'll be there. Let's get started. So raw umber, of course, is my favorite drawing color. And let me go ahead and check out the messages so far. Hey Shindy Proba, sorry I mispronounced your name. Hi, I'm very new to painting and your channel. I like your oil painting. I would love to learn from your tutorial. My Facebook request. Oh, I'm going to get to that, the Facebook. Don't worry, everyone. I'm a little bit slower when it comes to the Facebook photo reference group, but I'll be getting to that shortly. So starting off, and again, I'm going to go ahead and accept everyone in the Facebook photo reference group. It does take a while to get to all of that. So I want the hat to be cropped. a little bit. So I want to say right about here. By the way, the photo reference is posted in the community section of the YouTube page. Please always check the community section in case there are any delays or I have to miss a stream or something. That sometimes happens, but just check the community section for me. Starting off with the hat, I'm going to place the hat in the corner. So this is going to be another Halloween type inspired painting, in that I actually have already planned out the composition. So I like the thing that she's wearing, the kind of moon shape that she's wearing, the jewelry. I'm actually going to put something over here later on in the painting, like a crescent moon or something like that. Kind of like a purplish blue type of sky or evening sky background. So right now I'm just trying to figure out really the size of the face, the placement of the face. I'm starting off with simple straight lines and angles. To address the master study question, yes, I still have an ongoing master study that's going on, but that's with the online class, the online students. It's called Project 3. I know, not very creative titles, but Project 3 is actually a master study of the pearl earring painting by Vermeer. So I'm actually going to move the whole head a little bit to the left. And I think that this should be about good. I'm just moving everything about, like, I don't know, like a couple millimeters to the left. So again, feel free to ask me anything, but it will take me a little bit. Hey, Carol, welcome. Hangrid, do you have templates of the? Yes, I do, for the Vermeer in particular, the ongoing project, which is actually, well, anyway, the Vermeer, there is a template already created and accessible to the online students. And yep, and if you like the stream, please feel free to leave a like. Hey, Halim. So, one thing to mention with the start of a painting, it's not always this way, but sometimes with the start of a painting, there tends to be more comments, and this is good. I like to have more comments and more dialogue, but just know that with the start of every painting, there's usually it's usually going to be a little bit harder for me to answer questions and paint at the same time. So if I miss your messages, or if I miss your comments, please, if you don't mind, sending me another message. Another thing I'm going to do, as I decided before, I already kind of predetermined this composition. I'm moving up her her clothing. I'm moving it up because right around here is where I want to have that element of jewelry. Over here, I'm going to want to have a crescent moon or some kind of moon shape. And I want the head to be higher up in the composition, as you're seeing here, but not overly centered either. So it's a little bit higher up and not overly centered. Hey, Muhammad. Lots of love and support from Suleiman Shah Strong Tribe. Oh, thank you for the shout out from Turkey. Thank you so much. Hey, Bomar338, isn't it better if I start off painting with color out? I usually start with monochrome, and that's the way I pretty much start everything. Unless we're talking about in the online classes, I always suggest that my students do the transfer drawings, but I'm just starting off with a very simplistic drawing. And the beginning of a painting is always a very exciting and terrifying time. You know, especially if you're going to be doing a, you know, a painting of someone you know, or if you're painting in front of an audience or something like that. So the most important thing in the beginning, I'll say even more important than trying to get the super accuracy in the beginning, is to loosen up. See how the brush is moving freely. I'm probably going to be holding the brush from back here for a pretty long time. And then As many of you have noticed, it does tend to slow down a little bit later on as the painting progresses. The likeness, I can guarantee you, is not going to be all the way there by the end of today, the start. The likeness is going to be built more and more later on. Hey, Julie, Diana One. Okay. Hey, Lorraine. Hello there from the UK. Thanks for watching from the UK. Halima, I'm using raw umber. Whoops, I accidentally got ivory black. Actually, I'm going to just switch to a different brush. I just want to use raw umber for now. This is almost like a chocolate looking color. Raw umber, this is from the brand Winsor Newton. I usually use a different raw umber though to tone. I actually have two different raw umbers. I have the one I'm using right now is artist grade. It is Winsor Newton. The one I used to tone, however, is professional grade Rublev. The reason I use Rublev to tone is because I find that it settles a little more quickly than Winsor Newton. So the beginning is going to be really, really abstract. It's not going to look like anything for a good long while. And you want to train yourself to use simple shapes, abstract shapes, learn to reason with shapes. Don't get caught up in the pressure factor of portrait painting. Let's see. Hey, Mohammed, my uncle Kurdoglu is an artist and works in Dukrama tribe. Oh, awesome. Awesome. All right. So right now, what I'm trying to do is put in just a few simple shapes and steer those shapes more specific. Like last time I said that I put, I don't know what number I said. I think I said about like 83 or 84 or something shapes. Obviously, it's an exaggeration because I can't know exactly how many shapes it is unless I was a computer. And I'm going to be moving the shapes around for a pretty long time. So you want to start off, keep everything simple and basic. As I always say, I don't recommend starting out the way I do. I actually recommend starting off with a transfer drawing, as I always tell my students. And I create drawing templates for them to assist them in the beginning of the, especially in the drawing stage. This technique that I'm showing you is my technique. It's how I draw. It's how I paint. I use mass and line kind of all at once. And I kind of have a mix between alla prima and classical. But when I teach, for instance, today I was actually, this morning I was teaching a lesson on practical figure drawing, introducing anatomical landmarks and things like that for my students. It's way more technical, whereas what you're seeing now is how I paint. You know, I'm much more loose. I move much more quickly. I edit a lot. It's a different kind of mindset. Oftentimes, some viewers will refer to these as lessons. These are not lessons. These are virtual painting sessions. If this was intended to be a lesson, then it would be, of course, way more slow paced, and everything would be explained for the sake of having more understanding for the students. What you're seeing here is like a million miles per hour of painting speed in comparison to how I teach my classes. So as I said, I edit this and I edit this because I have a composition in mind that I want. And I'm going to not put the flowers in there. Instead, there's going to be kind of a little bit of a variation in the value for the sky. But again, up here is going to be a crescent moon kind of thing. Composition is going to go down towards here, towards the face, and then down towards here where the element of jewelry is going to show somewhere about there. So let's see. I may have missed some comments, so I'm going back to the comments right now. Hey, Charles Ward, how you party? One of these days, can you do a painting with the blue underpainting portrait, still life landscape, whichever is appropriate, something blue. There's a term for that. I forgot what the term is. It's like slipping my mind. The term for a blue underpainting. I forgot the term, but there's a term for that. I can do that, but the thing is, it would expedite, or the drying time would take forever. Hey, Brian Ross, whereabouts in America? I am in Beltsville, Maryland. Good old PG County. Hey, Lorraine, what medium are you using at this point? I'm not using any medium, so my medium is usually right there, but it's not here today. I usually don't start off with medium, so I'm just using the paints by themselves and thinning out with solvent whenever need be. And the solvent I'm using is Gamsol. And this is just my eraser brush, which is a pretty used up bristle brush. As you notice, I haven't really done much for the face. I'm trying to establish the entire picture before getting hung up on any kind of details. Hey Charles, yes, blue paint in general will dry more slowly than raw umber. What I like about raw umber for the start of paintings is that it dries really fast. That's one thing. But another thing is the value itself of raw umber. It's not as dark as ivory black. So it actually compresses the value range really nicely. And I also like that it leans itself pretty well towards layering skin colors on them for portraiture. And then it's also a nice kind of neutral color when you mix white into it. A nice neutral gray. That's a good underpainting color for pretty much anything, any subject matter. Hey, Leslie Hayes. Thanks for watching from Spain. Hey, I'm Kutch. It's cold in Utah. It's cold over here. I'm wearing a sweater. It's cold over here in Maryland. Probably not as cold, but it's kind of cold for me too. It's one of those situations when it's hot outside, it's hot in here. When it's cold outside, it's cold in here. But it's so much easier to heat than the cool. I'll take the cool over the heat any day. Hey Mohammed, what time is it in your city? Oh, it's nighttime over there. Wow. It's 5:50. Wow, it's already been 20 minutes. Yeah, it's 5:50. Hey, Huma Haroon. Yes, this is oil painting. So for beginners, I always suggest to have a more finished linear drawing, which I refer to as the block in, for beginners and for advanced painters alike. The main thing about this approach that you're seeing me use here is the fact that it's very fast, it's very efficient, but it's a little harder to draw like this. I will admit that. But it's just my own way that I've adapted to in painting, but definitely I highly suggest for beginners out there to spend a lot of time drawing. In particular, that's why I create the templates for my students, which again, the templates are meant to help them with the linear drawing. So right now I'm multitasking. I'm dealing with the initial layer of the painting. I'm also speaking to the public, and I'm also handling the paint, so building the paint layer at the same time. And if you're new to painting, starting off like this can be a little stressful. Some really enjoy it, others again find it really stressful, but my biggest advice would be to have really solid linear block-ins, meaning simple straight lines and angles that convey the sense of proportion, placement, composition. Hey, Mohammed. Yes, this is oil painting. I'm wondering, this is looking a little strange on my camera. Hold on a second. Had to adjust the lighting a little bit there. It was actually picking up a lot of Oh, thanks, Mohammed. Ingrid, you like short handle brushes? Those are nice too. I'll probably switch to short handle brushes in a little bit. Apologize there. I had to adjust the light. It looks like the camera was kind of overexposing a little bit. Speaking of multitasking, I'm also my own camera person, so gotta do all of these things at once, which is actually a lot of fun, if you would ask me. Also, the photo reference. I edited the photo reference. I bumped up the contrast. I pushed up the difference between light and shadow a little bit on this. Just because the photo reference on its own is a little hard to differentiate. It's a little hard to differentiate between the light and the shadow. And it's still a little bit more in the complex side. Just letting you know I had to edit that. And again, it's going to look like an educated mess for a long time. Oh, thank you, Pink Lila. Hey, Abu Omar 338. I'm a painter from Saudi Arabia. Is it important measuring the dimensions of the portrait with a ruler after finishing the work before displaying it? I think so. But even before that, I think it's important to, at least when you're painting, to know the dimensions of it. So, for instance, this is 1114. And I know this isn't much of anything now, but it will be available for sale as a special on the last day that this is going to be shown on YouTube. And the reason I like 1114 inches, I don't know what the conversion is off the top of my head in centimeters, is because it's such an easy size to frame. So you always want to think about the potential buyers and make their lives a little easier and paint in standard sizes. Oh, thanks for the emojis, Barry Allen. Oh, thank you, Leslie Hayes. All right, let me see. I think I missed something. Hey, Alberto, my question would be, What treatment do you do to your painting surface? Because it seems very flat, like paper, not like normal canvas. This is actually the texture of the panel, and I have this listed in the description box as my favorite panel. I actually don't do anything to it. I like the surface so much that all I do is just tone it with the oil paint. And even today, I just toned it a couple hours, and it actually settled in pretty nicely. It's not subtracting that much. It's not the same with every panel, though. Sometimes I do have to add extra gesso to the surface. Sometimes I have to. This one, not so much. I really like this panel. This is the one that I always recommend to my students. Hey, Muhammad, isn't eating an art? Well, it can be, yeah. Hey, Sam Hibbs, what type of brush are you using? Bristles, stiff or soft? These are soft acrylic brushes that I'm using to draw, but I'm actually using stiff bristle brushes or a stiff bristle brush to erase. See this? I can't erase completely, but I can erase enough to move the paint around. Now, I want to emphasize that I am just beginning this painting today, so I don't guarantee there's just going to be much of a likeness, and it may not even look human for a very long time. But that's just the way it is. You usually, if you jump in and make it too human too soon, then that's when you can run into problems with looking into the painting too much. Too much as a portrait painting and not enough as a painting itself. Yep, no problem, Sam Hibbs. Let's see. Hey Monique, yeah, 11 by 14 is like one of my favorite sizes for a portrait. Hey, Suleiman. Hey Pari, my brother, Muhammad, told me about you, and it's my first comment on your live. Oh, thank you. Thanks for joining the live stream. Shout out to you. So anyone that is new to the live stream, let me know. And I will give you a shout out with the paintbrush. By the way, remember, everyone, please remember that since this is the start of a painting, it's usually there's usually more comments. So I may end up missing a comment or two. Nothing personal. It's just some kind of I'm not that quick of a reader, so again. And also, I'm going to show this from time to time. The sale special or the special for today. This painting, if it's purchased during the stream today, you will get a bonus painting study only if it's purchased today. And I'll know if it's purchased today because we actually will hear. Etsy will let us know. So again, here is the special for today. And if you do purchase this painting today, again, link in the description, you do get a bonus study painting, but only for the duration of this stream. Then it goes back to normal. And here is the shop itself, so you can see all of the paintings that are currently available. At the moment, all of the portraits have been sold out, but these are the paintings that are currently still available. Paintings are available at first come, first serve basis. All right, so now that I have the basic block in, I'm not going to dread over trying to get the outlines to be perfect. As I said, this is going to be a mix between alla prima and classical. So right now, I'm going to switch gears to alla prima mode. So I'm going to actually start to mix some values to draw with, in particular to help me draw over here. But before I do that, I'm actually going to tone the background a little bit more because it's actually going to be kind of distracting. And then if anyone's wondering how I tone my surfaces, it's exactly like this. The background, I'm going to be editing the background. So earlier today, a couple hours ago, I did this exact same process to the painting surface. For those of you that are wondering how I prepared the surface. And I'm going to change the lighting. She's going to be in kind of twilight light scene. I already have the composition mapped out in my head. So she's going to be in a kind of twilight setting. Not like the movie or TV show Twilight, but actual like twilight lighting. And I need this to be darker because I'm going to be putting in a lot of texture to the skin tone. So with the different touch, I have a lighter value. I'm scattering the paint more. Whereas I didn't have the same kind of touch here. So that's how you're seeing the difference in the tonality. And this is why I really, really like this painting surface. The Ampersand Gesso Board Museum series, because look at it. It's just taking the paint like a champ. I didn't add any extra gesso or anything. This is just how it is stock with a little bit of the tone that I added earlier today. All right, let's see what I have missed. Oh, thank you so much for your super chat, Suleiman. Thank you so much. Let's do a little trick here with the paintbrush, and shout out to you. Thank you so much for your help here with my live stream with the YouTube channel. Thank you so much, Suleiman. I really appreciate your support here. Alrighty, let's see. Hey, Ingrid, you use Griffin Alkyd. Well, guess what? We're actually going to be doing that. Hey, Suleiman, again, thank you so much for your donation to my YouTube channel. It really does help me out so much. Again, thank you so much. And also, Suleiman, here, please, if you are interested in a free sample lesson, I'm going to type out my Gmail for you. And this applies to everyone else as well. So in your email, just write super chat. So there's my Gmail. It's my name and then theartist@gmail.com. So it should show up sometime soon. So Suleiman, if you are interested in a free sample lesson to my online classes, again, here's the link to that down here. Just go ahead, send me an email, and make sure to title in your email super chat so I know that this was you in the blue, and I will go straight to the email that's titled super chat so I know that it was you. So thank you again for your support. So Ingrid, you were mentioning the Griffin Alkyd. I'm actually going to show you, I'm going to show everyone a little painterly trick. Maybe it's not so much painterly, but it's kind of a painting trick. So this is what I'm going to do. This is the Griffin Alkyd, the Griffin Alkyd Titanium White. So Griffin Alkyd Titanium White. No more than that. I'm just going to use a little bit because a little bit of Alkyd paint goes an extremely long way. And I'm going to actually be using that with flake white. Yep, with flake white. I know, crazy, right? But you can do this with titanium white as well. So again, I'm just going to take whatever's left from the palette. And then I'm going to add a little bit more. So this is flake white. Now, Williamsburg flake white. So what I'm going to do is utilize my chair to squeeze a little bit of paint out. And There we go. Now I'm going to be mixing them shortly. Now, as you see, I have a lot more flake white than the titanium Griffin Alkyd. Now I'm going to mix them. Why am I using Griffin Alkyd? Because it is a really, really fast dryer. I hope I have that linked in the description. If I don't, just look up Griffin Alkyd, you know, Griffin like the bird, Griffin Alkyd. And you want to add just, again, a little bit. I may have added too much there, but we'll find out later. And that's just going to help to expedite the drying process. All right, now let's go ahead and start to draw. So I always say to start with the most obvious, and what I'm going to do is make my life a little easier because the brush accidentally got into the ivory black before, which I don't want because it's a very slow dryer. So I'm just going to put some extra raw umber there. And what I'm going to do is add the most obvious shapes that I'm noticing first. This is probably the first time you've ever seen me mix titanium white and flake white at the same time. That just goes to show you that it's really not one or the other. You want to be able to know how to use everything to its full advantage. Now, this was the most obvious thing for me to notice, this light. And I always say with the early layers in a painting to work lighter and softer than you initially or than you ultimately want the painting to be. So even though this area is lighter than this area, it doesn't matter. I can group them together and make them almost straight titanium white. Hey, nice name, Renoir Shine. Sir, I want to learn your kind of skill. It's my job. Oh, thank you so much for your wonderful comment. Again, anyone that's interested in studying with me, again, my classes are $10 a month, and that's really the best way to contact me, the easiest, I want to say, just because it's not just the online classes, it's also the connection that we establish with the online classes, the online class community. Which again is completely different to this. Now the fundamentals are universal. So I have students that use acrylic paint. I have students that use gouache, water mixable oil paints, a whole array of different tools. And it's the fundamentals that are universal. So it doesn't matter what material you're using, or if you're an advanced painter or just beginning. The online classes are set up for anyone of any level to join in. Hey, Reach 3D Printers. Gotta have a community of artists to learn from. I'm really thankful for my online class community. I mean, everyone is so welcoming. We always have a very informative time in the virtual painting or virtual classroom, which is every Tuesday evening. And And also there's, again, the online classes are $10 a month, but there's also an option to watch the lessons as they are created. In a sense, it's like receiving the lessons early and also being able to watch them as they're created. That one is the live stream tier, which is the ultimate tier, the highest level tier on my Patreon. Hey, Reach 3D Printers. If you don't mind, do me a favor and check out the online classes again. If you just type out right here, patreon.com/YupariArtist on your browser, it should show up. I also have the link in the description and the painting that is for sale at the moment is also linked. I'll tell you what, I think that I've messed the eye up. I think I made it a little small. So I'm going to quickly blur it. Yes, 3D printer, thank you so much. Hey Tech, hi Yupari, just joined Patreon classes over the weekend. Is this photo going to be available to students? Sure. Oh, by the way, I'm still creating the template for the, like, two portraits ago, the hat, as I had some suggestions to create drawing templates for that. If online students, if you're interested in a drawing template of this photo reference here, I can also create a template for you of this one. And yeah, I can post this in the online classes. All right, so the most obvious error for me was the size of the eye, the placement of the eye. And as I said in the beginning, I tend to go for the most obvious stuff. So for me, these lights are the absolute most obvious things. And even if I get them wrong, even if I place them in the wrong spot, which I most likely will, if I keep my shapes simple and easy, then when it's time, as I always say, when it's time to make changes, those changes are simple and easy to manage. And that's what you want. You don't want painting to be a drag. You don't want it to be, you don't want it to be not fun. You don't want to be restricted. And periodically, I'm going to have to lift this up so I can so I can see it without the distortion. Because again, I'm painting at a 45 degree angle. So yeah, the eyes are definitely too close to one another. So I'm going to get a halftone brush and move them. Let's see. Hey, Sulema. I have no clue what the viewer is writing. Let me check. Hey, silly man. Yeah, I wouldn't worry about what they're writing. Alright. Alright, I'm gonna just try to focus on the painting. Yes, silly man. Yeah, I wouldn't worry too much about the comment. All right. Sorry about you being kind of weird. Gonna have to. Yeah, I don't know. You're being kind of weird. Sorry. I hate to do that, but I'm sorry, man. Sorry, Predator 75. That was kind of weird. Let me see. Hey, Bridget, can you join your classes as a beginner? Yep, you can join as a beginner. I always recommend the project number two for beginners. And again, for the most part, Bridget, the beginners are about 95% of the online class community when they start. And I have students that start with no experience, and they're thriving. They learn so quickly. It's wonderful. And again, the online classes are set up so you can work at your own pace. You're not obligated to submit anything. And you know, you have all the time you need. Of course, students have the ability to send me images each week for the virtual classroom. But again, it's not, you know, it's not like you're going to be, you know, forced. It's all at your own pace. I have students that send me images monthly, students that send me images weekly, others that send me images every couple months. So it's really at your own pace. Hey, Suleiman. Oh, thank you so much. I mean, as I mentioned, I do have the paintings on the Etsy store. Oh, thank you for the kind gesture there. So what I'm doing is I'm using shape to move this eye to the left, and I'm focusing on the main triangle right now, and I'm not terribly getting caught up with any of the shapes down here just yet. Thank you so much, Teak. Thank you so much for your support on my live stream. Thank you so much for the support. And Suleiman, I wouldn't worry that commenter is gone. Yeah, don't worry, Suleiman. I got you, buddy. Thank you. You have some great, refresh zone work from, I'm working through fundamentals of portrait. It's great so far. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you for, it sounds like you're actually already in the online classes. Again, it's kind of hard for me to keep track of the usernames, but, again, please feel free to send me an email also. Again, thank you so much for your support. And, so everyone wondering what the blue box is, that's the super chat. That highlights your message, and it also is a way to donate to my YouTube channel, because these things are kind of hard to create, but at the same time, the super chat, it's a way to support the creators that you enjoy watching during their live streams, and it also helps the creators see their message. So I was able to see Teak's message right away. What the? Hey, Predator75. Welcome back. Let's see. Hey, video game. How do you know how to evaluate your paintings? Do you add the hours it took? I usually go by, at this point, I have lowered my prices. It's usually kind of a supply-demand thing, like anything. But I usually try to group them together by size and the time, usually. So, for instance, my studio paintings are currently not for sale. It is the virtual painting sessions that I'm marketing to sell. I also like to combine the experience of, you know, the viewers or the potential buyers watching the painting get created. So for me, it's a little more complex than pricing it by the size or anything like that. It's also about the viewer's experience and then the viewer ultimately getting the opportunity to own the painting. So again, this one will be for sale when it's time. Hey, Pablo, in your experience, does I wouldn't write that here, Pablo. I'm going to have to actually hide that comment. Apologize. Yeah, sorry, I have to remove that one, Pablo. Okay, we can't talk about that because that's going to get me in trouble. Sorry, I'm removing a bunch of comments. All right. So let's get started drawing the bottom. Yeah, no worries. So anyone whom I had to delete your messages, don't take it personal. It's just I have to keep track of the YouTube algorithm. Things like that can get me in trouble with the comments. No worries, Pablo. I understand. It's just I have to keep track of the YouTube robots. Now I'm putting in another half tone on the side of the philtrum. And I'm going to switch to a larger brush in a minute here, just so I can cover a little faster. Hey, Jean Fernandez. Saludos acá a través de este Perú. Saludos desde Beltsville, Maryland. And again, I should show this periodically. I'm running a special sale during this stream, so if anyone does decide to purchase this painting that I'm about to show you right now, this painting is linked in the description box down below as today's special. And if you do purchase this painting today, I'm going to show you. I have it right here. The link is in the description box. So if you do decide to purchase this original painting of mine that has been signed already, you get a bonus painting study on a sheet of cotton canvas. So this will come in your package as a bonus if you purchase today. Not this painting per se, but a surprise study. So not this one, but it is you will have a surprise painting as part of the special of buying a painting that is featured as a special during a live stream. So this only applies to the purchase of that painting during this live stream. And we're going to run the same special for this one, but only when this one is in its last layer. And it's at a first come, first serve basis. At the moment, all of the portrait paintings have been purchased. Oh, thanks, Pablo. I just read your message. Hey, Pablo. Actually, YouTube itself did give me a hard time. I don't think it's just for, like, larger streamers. I think it's just YouTube. The YouTube machine learning is very, very tricky. Hey, Maku Castillo. It's a pity I don't speak English to understand your comments. I love your portrait so much. Oh, thank you so much. Let's see. Oh my god, you said per se. I don't know why put I find it when people say it's satisfying. Oh, thank you. And you know, a really nice thing about combining Alkyd, Griffin Alkyd with flake white is you have the texture of the flake white, that kind of like stringy type of thickness to the paint, and the fast drying nature, the ultra fast drying nature of the Griffin Alkyd. Hey Ingrid, more paintings like the pearl earring. So at the moment with the virtual painting sessions, they tend to go through series. For instance, it began with the master studies. But the problem is, the more master studies I do, the less original work I can create. At the moment, I'm just doing the originals. My intent with these is to create an experience for the viewers to see how I actually create a painting, like an original painting. But the Ingrid, I'm actually considering another Rembrandt, but as project 5 or 6 in the online classes. Hey Oscar, be careful with your language, buddy. I don't know what's going on here. No, 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 Oscar, he didn't mean the painting. He didn't mean the painting. All right. Whoever wrote that, you've been kicked out. All right, so no fighting in the comments, or I will turn the comments off. Oh, thanks for defending me, Oscar. Let's just you can defend me. Just as no fighting words, or I will turn the chat off. Or else, you know, YouTube will strike me down. Hey Ingrid. The stream is dead. Okay, sorry. So I want to look at the distance of the philtrum and oh, thanks, Glenn. I'm glad my videos help you. I'm sorry about the stroke. Oh, thanks, Reach 3D Printers. I did lower it, the price. So right now I'm at I have the most ability to lower or to raise the position of the philtrum here. So I think at the moment it should be about good. I just have to raise it a tiny bit higher. All right, so I'm gonna be kicking out quite a few comments from here. No, silly man, I didn't block you. It was someone else. You're good, buddy. Hey Danilo, hello there from Brazil. Let's see. Hey Reach 3D Printers, I always love to look at Nelson Shank's work. Unfortunately, he passed away in 2015, but I refer to him as my superhero. He is one of my absolute favorite painters. I'm gonna type his name out. Yep. Yeah, definitely be careful with the wording on this chat. And also, please look at the community section of the YouTube channel for updates. For instance, I'm probably gonna have to be updating you after this one. Hey Bert 2008, I need Dondo. He's not here. Bert 2008 before 6ix9ine, man. This stream has been kind of hectic. Kind of hectic. But we're pushing through. What would be nice is to have someone working with me, reading the comments to me during the stream. That would be nice. Yeah, this has been wild. Thanks, Predator 75. Video game. Yep, I'm putting her in a different setting. She's gonna be in a twilight setting, crescent moon. I've moved her shirt up. All right, so this painting, I believe, has now been purchased. Hold on, I'm going to double check. So I have set my software to notify me during the stream. Hold on a second. I'm gonna confirm it with you. Okay, so this painting offer has now expired because someone already owns this painting. So thank you so much. This painting is now going to be prepared to be sent to its forever home, along with a surprise painting study. So this one has been sold, therefore the let's see here. So again, this special has now ended because the painting has been purchased. So as I always say with these live streams, the paintings are for sale at a first come, first serve basis. So thank you so much for your purchase of this painting, if you're still watching the live stream right now, and I will be contacting you on Etsy and creating the box to ship the painting out to you. Thank you so much. And as always, whenever a painting is sold during the live stream, you will receive a bonus painting study on a sheet of cotton canvas. And of course, I would like to do a backflip right now, but I can't do a backflip during the stream. Yep, thanks, Alberto. Thanks for the congratulations. Oh, you know what, everyone? I do want to do I've had this idea in mind of an acrylic pumpkin painting live stream. I don't know how I'm gonna set it up, but yesterday I actually painted a pumpkin. I painted Beetlejuice on a pumpkin at my fiance's family's place. I may do that for one of these days. But I don't know because this painting is set to be completed by Saturday, and Saturday is Halloween, so maybe we'd have to do that on a different day. Oh, thanks, Monique. And congratulations to you, if you're watching the stream right now for your purchase. You have definitely made my day. Now, clearly, as I moved up I shrank the filter a little bit, a teeny tiny bit. I'm also going to have to adjust the mandible. Hey, Predator 75, will you paint in pastel color? I can experiment with pastel, but to be honest, most of my experience is in oil paint, but I do have some acrylic experience. For instance, I was actually painting with acrylic yesterday. I was painting a pumpkin. I painted Beetlejuice. But I am overrun with joy for the painting that has just sold. Oh, Tech bought it. Thank you so much, Tech. I am ecstatic. I am ecstatic. Trying to hold my composure, but I am ecstatic. It's like a dream come true for me whenever a painting is sold. I paint with acrylic. I'm too scared to try oil, plus I don't have the patience to wait for oil paint to dry. So that's a situation where Griffin Alkyd would really help. So the nice thing about oil paint is that you can control the drying time. It's never going to dry as fast as acrylic, but you can make it dry within a day. Hey, sweet Siddhi Gupta. I am from Beltsville, Maryland. I was born in Bethesda, Maryland. I'm a Marylander. Definitely Marylander. Hey, Alberto BPH. Why acrylic and not oil for the pumpkin? Because of the drying time. Since we're talking about drying time, I put a lot of layers for the painting of Beetlejuice. And I don't know why I didn't take a picture of it, but the next time I'm at my fiance's family's place, I'll take a picture of it. Or maybe I can just ask them to send me a picture of it. Hey, Siddhi, oh wow, it's 4:10 a.m. over there. Wow. I'm very appreciative of your motivation to view the stream. I am going to give you a shout out with my paintbrush for w watching at 4:10 a.m. Wow. Yep, it's true. With acrylic, you do have to paint really quickly. Hey, Matt K. It's raw umber. I know it looks like burnt umber, doesn't it? But when you mix it with flake white or titanium white, it turns that beautiful warm gray. But no, it's not raw umber. But I've had plenty of questions from my students as to if it's okay to use burnt umber, and it is. You can use burnt umber. I just use raw umber because of its kind of cooler, not cool as in like too cool for school, but cool as in temperature cool, coolness. Whereas burnt umber is a little too warm for me these days for underpaintings. The paintings that are purchased also come with certificates of authenticity with matching signatures, by the way, for verification of the painting in the future. Man, all of you are really making my dreams come true as a painter. And I sincerely mean it with all of my soul. I had no clue how, this would be what it is today. It's just amazing for me. It's incomprehensible. Hey, Matt K, how did you get the yellow underneath? So let's see if I can subtract a little bit. Don't mind me, I'm actually going to just subtract a little bit with paper towel. This kind of yellowish color that you're seeing is actually the influence of raw umber thinned out with solvent over top of the gesso. See here how I've actually subtracted a little bit? That's the gesso. So this is the color of raw umber itself thinned out on top of the white gesso. Hey, Siddhi Gupta, can you tell me in oil painting what is the ratio to be taken in colors and linseed oil? You don't have to worry about the ratios in the beginning. As the layers progress, you just need to use more oil. And in the beginning, the best thing to do is not to use any oil or any medium. I'm not using any medium, just oil paints. One can consider the Griffin alkyd as a medium, but that alkyd is actually mixed into the paints. Hey, Regina. Cabanas, hello. Yep, fat over lean. So let me talk about fat over lean. So fat over lean means, in essence, you want the earlier layers to dry before the later layers in an oil painting. The way you can achieve that is to not use too many mediums or oils in the beginning of a painting. So to make it even more simple, fat over lean in oil painting, all you have to do is in your underpainting, don't use any medium. Just use the paint itself. And if you don't want to wait for the paint to take forever to dry, use a fast drying oil paint. That's all. Problem solved. Hey Jalen, Tomlin, I'm all right. I'm actually more than I'm all right. I'm ecstatic. We actually I'm always going to have a special, or at least I'm aiming to always have a special sale with each live stream. And again, I have links to the Etsy store in the description, but I'm doing pretty good, I will say. I hope everyone else is having a good day today. Does anyone else paint pumpkins as a tradition, like a fall tradition or something? Because we kind of do that every year. Last year I painted the mask, you know, the mask, the movie starring Jim Carrey. Last year I painted the mask onto the pumpkin. Onto a pumpkin. Whoa. Now I'm gonna have to switch brushes. Hey, Regina Cabanas. Oh, thank you. So, we should be live again on Wednesday for the continuation of this painting. If you see me painting and I forget to put the alkyd, the fast drying alkyd into the flake white, just stop me and say, "Yo, you forgot to put the alkyd in the paint," because that way I can ensure that the layers are dry when they need to be. Like last time, I actually had to skip a day of streaming because the painting wasn't ready to work on yet. And again, I'm editing the bottom here. So I know that her dress goes a little bit lower, but I'm editing it because I want to paint this element of jewelry that she's wearing here, and then I'm going to match it with a crescent moon in the sky. Hey Alberto, in Peru there are almost no pumpkins, but a lot of candies and costumes. Oh, awesome. I also found out that in some countries there's not a lot of pumpkin pie. And I love pumpkin pie. I don't know what I would do without pumpkin pie. And for anyone that hasn't tried pumpkin pie, try pumpkin pie. It's so good. As I said, this is a virtual painting session. So again, I'm painting at my own pace. I wouldn't confuse this with an online lesson. Again, the online lessons are filmed on the same mornings that I do these streams. So this morning at 9 a.m., I filmed a lesson, practical figure drawing lesson, including anatomical landmarks. And that video is actually already available for my online students. And again, the link to the online classes is over here. If you just would copy and paste patreon.com/upariartist, it's only $10 a month. You remind me of Julian from Baumgartner Restoration. I wonder if that's a good thing. I don't know of this person. I'm sorry. Hey, Julie Dino One. No pumpkin pie here in the UK. Oh my goodness. I did hear this before. Wow. I can't imagine. I can't imagine fall or autumn, however we want to call it, without pumpkin pie. Now, as I mentioned with the underpainting, I always suggest to work lighter and softer. So see how there are almost no sharp edges except for this one. Even the hat is not that sharp of an edge yet. It will be, but not yet. So again, this is a mix between alla prima, which is what I'm doing right now. I'm painting wet onto wet, and the classical approach. Classical approach, or traditional approach, however you want to call it, is I define it as a painting that has a series of steps which involves multiple layers, as opposed to a painting that has just a single layer. But different terminology will vary from artist to artist. Yes, it's a YouTube channel. He restores old paintings. Awesome. I didn't know. I gotta check that out. Thank you. Whew. I am definitely, I've been taken through an emotional roller coaster today, and it's been wonderful. So I recommend to you, when you're painting and you know that you're going to continue working on a painting, always ask yourself, what can I solve? What problems can I solve right now that will help me in the next painting session? So right now, the biggest thing for me to resolve is the big shapes, the big placements, and painting it in such a way that I can easily maneuver the paint, meaning I don't want to have any overly sharp lines. I don't want to have any overly sharp edges. I want everything to be soft and malleable, versatile, just easy to compose, easy to rearrange. So to speak, I want the painting to be easygoing. I want it to be easygoing. So when I return to it, it's going to be a fun time building onto it. Hey Mark, Keenan, what type of brush are you using for the highlights? So I tend to be a little controversial with brushes. Now I am a very practical painter. I would like to think. I don't spend a lot of money on brushes. Instead, I spend more money in my painting support and my oil paints. That's what I spend the most money in. Therefore, the brushes that I'm using for the highlights and for everything are very inexpensive brushes. Except for my favorite brush, this one, Princeton Catalyst Polytip Bristle. These brushes last forever. They're really good for covering large surfaces in your painting, as you saw me covering over here. In fact, I'm about to use it right now. This was my most expensive brush, probably running at about, I don't know, like $10 or $15 US. But I tend to use synthetic brushes. Princeton Catalyst Polytip Bristle is a synthetic bristle mix. And the brush itself is called an Egbert. It's a filbert, but it's an awkward filbert. It's a very long, very long filbert, filbert brush. For my brushes, I just use whatever there is at Walmart at a time. Well, that's true. And again, I mean, if it works, it works. The same cannot be said for oil paints, unfortunately. You know, if you work with certain oil paints that are not, a high grade oil paint, it may seem to work perfectly fine. But somewhere down the line, maybe, I don't know, in 5 years or in 50 years, it could have some adverse effects, depending on the type of oil paint that you use. Example, in my lifetime, I've only seen one painting crack, and it was a painting made of me a long, long time ago. I won't disclose who painted it because it's the only painting I've seen that has cracked. But the artist used a lot of stand oil in one corner of the painting. It was an Alla Prima painting, by the way, and I think it was like a cheaper grade stand oil that they were using. I know because we were close friends. And I know from memory that the stand oil was very thick in this corner of that painting, and it's cracking. And I've never seen that happen in my lifetime. Fortunately for me, none of my paintings have cracked or have yellowed or anything. And all of my how long have I been painting now? 11 years. I still have my very first oil painting. It was a still life. It's titled "Who Moved My Bottle?" All right, so I'm gonna look at some of the comments, and then I'm going to adjust the mandible. The mandible is a little messed up. Hey, Reach 3D printers, cracks caused from fat over lean. Yep, exactly. Fat over lean. If one doesn't follow fat over lean very closely, again, you don't have to be too analytical about it. It's not really that complicated. It just means in the first layer, avoid oils. Especially stand oil in the first layer, avoid it. Later on, maybe in the second layer or something, then you can start to use medium. Not too much, but just enough. And then maybe in the third layer, and so on and so forth, you can introduce more and more medium. And that's all it is. Hey, artsy cat, I like your username. That happened to me too. Much oil and my paint cracked after about 20 years. Oh wow. I think this painting is only about like 9 or 10 years old. Hey, Reach 3D printers, dry the surface before. Yep. You want the early layers to dry first. Let's see. I hear rosemary makes the highest quality, but really you could make a brush from about anything that will transfer paint to canvas. This is true. Hey, Matt K, do you change to slower drying oils for the later part of the painting? Very, very good question, Matt K. You are very, very observant. I will, actually. In the last layer, I'm not going to use alkyd. I will not use alkyd in the last layer. Very good. Very good question there. Hey Alberto, this painting is technically alla prima, or is it the first layer of a multi-layer? And alla prima can convert into a multi-layer at the end depending on the time and difficulty. Yes, you are correct. Again, everyone is on point today. Thumbs up for everyone. You are all on point. Yes, this is an alla prima type start that is intended to be layered because though it's alla prima and fairly thick, I'm not putting any extra medium, and I'm using alkyd in the white, so it's a little bit of a thicker mixture. But thanks to the alkyd, this layer will be pretty much touch dry and ready to go in probably even less than 24 hours. Great observation. Okay, I think I've caught up with most of the questions and comments, at least from scrolling through. And again, if I missed anyone's comments, I apologize. Also, I want to make it known that I use different brushes, even though they look like the same brushes. I oftentimes get asked if I'm using the same brush because they look the same. They look the same, don't they? But no, they're different brushes. And what I do is I try to keep an organization of light brushes, middle tone brushes, and dark brushes. Matt asked if you use a limited palette. Thank you so much. I see. Thank you. Thank you. Again, if I miss a comment, please someone remind me. I do use a limited palette, and this is it. These are all the colors I use for portrait, for still life, for anything really. This is the palette I use. We'll get into the colors in the next time, but I use. I'll number how many there are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 colors is a very, very limited palette, especially for today's standards. What I do is I don't use too many colors, but what I do is I study them to the nth degree. Sometimes I'll switch my cadmium yellow with Gamboge Lake Extra Old Holland, but for the most part, the palette stays consistent. Thank you for pointing that out. Hey, Artsy Cat, thank you for the info for Reach 3D Printers. Let's see, Reach 3D Printers wrote, I hear liquin turns yellow after about 50 years. I've heard similar things about that. Hey, T-I-K, do you use a color wheel? Also, I have problems with getting to a color starting from the primaries. Any tips? I do use the Munsell. I use that. Munsell color theory is something that should be studied. It should be understood. It's not that complex, though. Color has three components: hue, value, chroma. So in essence, the value is the only component to the color right now that I'm focusing on. But later on, I will start to build the other aspects, the other dimensions, so to speak, of the Munsell color theory system. So hue, value, chroma. Right now, I'm just answering value. Hue and chroma will be dealt with on top of this, but it's much easier to work with value first than having to juggle hue, value, chroma all at once, not to mention drawing. Speaking of drawing, I definitely have to adjust the mandible there. Hey, Mercat, what is my red? My red here is cadmium red vermilion. My palette has grown from the Zorn palette. So yes, definitely. Hey, Tick. Oh, thank you. Thank you for your wonderful comment. Hey, Karam. Oh, thank you. Milson Holiday. You're such a great artist and teacher. Thank you. Thank you so much. And again, I apologize for all the comments that I may have missed. One piece of advice I always give. Hey, Harjot, am I painting Sabrina the Teenage? What's up, Harjot? Harjot has entered the chat. Are you painting Sabrina the Teenage Witch? She is definitely a mystical character in this composition. I don't know. I'm gonna have to get back to you on that with the symbol, but I think you're right. I use Unsplash and Pexels, copyright free references for my, or copyright free sources for my photo references. And I usually edit, actually I always edit the images as I go. As you notice, I changed the background. I've lifted this shirt up a little bit so that this element of jewelry will be there. And I'm also going to paint a crescent moon in the sky. Harjot, you're on to something there, buddy. Hey, Reach 3D Printers, my problem is chroma. I way oversaturate. I know the theory, but need to practice to tone those down. Oh, definitely. Chroma is like the number one thing that I see that can be a problem in skin tones in particular. The tendency is to oversaturate the skin tones. And with my in my online classes, I do break down the combinations of colors to achieve certain effects with a little more detail, just because, I mean, a whole video can be dedicated just to that with the online lessons. But in general, that's very common, that saturation can be a problem. Hey, creative girl of color with Danielle B. I like your username. Yay, I'm glad to see you live. Well, I'm glad to see you here joining the live. Finally get to chat with you. I live in Maryland too. What? You live in Maryland? Awesome. I'm in Beltsville, Maryland. When everything opens up again, I usually teach in Howard County, Maryland. Hey, Monique. So the background will be dark. It will be twilight, almost like an indigo blue, purplish. And then we're gonna have a crescent moon up there. Or I don't know. We're gonna have the moon here. I've left enough space. Should probably leave a mark or something so I can remember. Hey, Gavin. Hello. Hey, Artifacts Mom. Hello. So as I always say with the underpainting, you want the values to be lighter than need be, and you want the edges to be softer. And in general, you want everything to be more simple, and you build simple to complex. Hey, Dirt Racer 77, can you draw a race car? Actually, you know what? I used to, when I was a kid, like 6th grade, 5th grade, I used to keep a journal where I would draw cars and try to design them. You know, that's not a bad idea. The only thing with cars, though, is perspective. I'd have to have like a pretty good linear drawing first. But maybe we can Alla Prima a car one day. It's possible. If I were to draw a car, I'd probably want to draw a 370Z. That's like my favorite car at the moment. I really like Nissan. Or a GTR. That would be fun. Hey, creative girl of color with Danielle B. Yes, indeed. I wanted to see your class. Then the pandemic happened. Oh, well, I mean, it's going to start up again soon. No worries. No worries there. And I'll let everyone know. So if you if you are going to be following the future videos, there will probably be a point where I'm going to announce that my in-person classes have started in Maryland. But at the moment, they're not going to start anytime soon. The director has talked to me. Director of the school is suggested starting in the spring, so maybe, depending on how things go. Hey, Reach 3 Printers. Oh, I got an 86-3-300Z. Awesome. I used to have a 2003 Nissan 350Z. Back in my younger days, man, I do miss that car. I miss it every day. Right now, I just have I like the car that I have right now. It's more of a fuel economy car at this point. It's a Nissan Versa. But if we're talking about cars, I mean, I always want stick shift cars. For some reason, I've never liked automatic cars. I don't know. It's just a weird fact about me. Hey, creative girl of color. Yes, I've been following you for the last couple of years, so it'll be nice to hear. And you can call me Danielle. All right, I'll call you Danielle. Yeah, of course, would love to have you in the in-person classes. I miss the in-person classes, though. I do have the online classes now, Danielle. So, to be honest, the online classes are actually more. I would actually consider them to be a little more useful. I know that's not good marketing for my in-person classes, but the problem with the in-person classes that I always had was I could never get enough students to run a 3-hour class. And I always had to run 2-hour classes. So the best educational content from me is actually in the online classes. And it's much cheaper too, Danielle. They're $10 a month. Whereas in person was, I forgot, whatever the school set. So I'm just being honest with you about that one. I'll probably get in trouble for saying that from my school. Hey, Dave B, what happened to the Z? It started to burn oil. It started burning oil at about like 170,000 miles. So I decided to sell it. Of course, I sold it to a mechanic, and then I used that for down payment for my other car. But I do miss that car. Oh, I miss it so much. Hey, Bernadette, only tried once oil painting and it was a mess. Mixed colors with a black background, and every color I added turned into a greedy mess. I usually refer to the beginning as an educated mess. With oil paint, it's so much easier to work with large masses with oil painting. But again, in the online classes, again, everyone, the link is here. If you just type patreon.com/ipariartist, you'll see the online classes for $10 a month. I explain everything in much further detail than this. Again, this is a virtual painting session. But Danielle, I did have a lot of I'd say I think about like 90%, I think, or 80% or something of my students when I was teaching in person were actually followers of my YouTube channel. So that was a nice thing back then. I also remember getting one of my favorite things ever was getting recognized in the art store. You know, back before we had to wear masks, people would recognize me in the art store and in painting sessions. They would quote me. And I thought that was the coolest thing ever. Of course, that doesn't happen anymore. I guess mainly because, I don't know. I have to cover, we have to cover our faces in the stores. Hey, let's see. CXCTUS girl. Hello. Oh, you're new here. Shout out to you with the moving paintbrush. Special shout out to you for being a for this being your first time here. And again, everyone else, if this is your first time, my paintbrush and I will give you a shout out. Hey Danielle, I don't know. I've never considered myself to be like art famous or anything, but that was one of the nicest things that could, I don't know, could happen in an art store to be recognized. It was also around the time that I was doing the daily videos. So that was when you could actually see what I look like. Though now I would like to do that again with a second camera, but at the moment my computer is not equipped to run two cameras. In the future, I want to be able to swap between camera angles so I can talk to you directly. Hey Brandy. Yeah, that was something, huh? Hey Alberto, after seeing your two live streams and seeing that you get success with your promotions, I know that YouTube is very powerful. Well, thank you. I mean, YouTube is a double-edged sword, though. The thing is with YouTube, when things go wrong, they go really, really wrong. So the best thing to do is to just be honest with your followers and with your, from one creator to another. The best thing to do is to be true to yourself and to always be honest. As I always say, definitely check the community section of my YouTube channel because sometimes there are, days that I can't stream when I'm supposed to. Oh, hey, Kathy. Welcome to the virtual painting session of today. I hope that you enjoyed the anatomy lesson earlier this morning. I actually had to prepare for a long time before that lesson, Kathy. I had to look up all of my old anatomical terms from the past. Hey Erwin, oh thank you. Hey Brandy, oh I'm glad you like the witch hat. Actually, now that you mention it, it's too big. It's a little wide. Hey Brandy, oh thank you. Hey Brandy. Hey Danielle. Spill the tea. Is there drama going on? At the moment, no, I don't think there is. I mean, the only thing is that again with live streams with live streams, I can't creators can't control what is said in the comments. So any one comment that YouTube decides to take off, it kind of punishes the creator, unfortunately. So that's really the only the negative that has happened recently with YouTube and me. But lately, it hasn't been too much of an issue. Oh, thanks, Artifex Mom. Hey, Kathy, love the anatomy lesson. My drawing of the anatomy points is still on my coffee table. Awesome. Well, yeah, definitely the anatomical landmarks are important as to place the parts is what my teacher would always tell me. It's important to place the parts. But in practice, I don't usually say, "Oh, there's the acromion process. There's the sternocleidomastoid, I don't always say, oh, there's the xiphoid process. Instead, sometimes I'll use the points, Kathy, to pinpoint the length of the femur bone, the length of the tibia, fibula, and all that. But for the most part, I use those landmarks as something just in the back of my mind as I'm drawing. It's the same as when we went over the anatomy for the portrait. Hey, Danielle. Oh yeah, don't worry. As long as there are no curse words or any kind of fighting going on in the comments, then we're good. Hey, Monique. Will you continue to do online classes even when you go back to in-person? Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I can say with 110%, 120 whatever percent certainty, I will continue the online classes. Definitely. The online classes are just getting started. We're definitely going to have more and more content there. You know, and you know how everyone says nothing is forever. So even when YouTube goes under, which everything does at some point, the online classes will continue. All I have to do is just switch from YouTube to Vimeo or something. I don't know, but the online classes will survive even YouTube. But I never want to see YouTube go away. YouTube is part of my soul. I remember watching the older YouTube videos when I was a kid. I would watch inline skating videos. And this was before YouTube had any of the ads and everything. Which, by the way, for the most part, sometimes there are little mistakes here and there, but for the most part, the online lessons don't have any ads. I take them off. I even have to write to YouTube and Google to say, hey, take the ads off these videos. Even it costs me to do that, but I make sure that there aren't. I do everything I can to ensure there are no ads playing during my lessons. But when it comes to public videos, ads are unfortunately a necessary evil. Without them, we creators wouldn't be able to make a living, to be frank. Yep, the passive income. It's not so passive though, Alberto, because we do have to constantly put things out there. Hey, Ellie, you know it's bad when your ad lags out. Oh, yeah, I know the feeling. Hey, Brandy, I'm getting paints for Christmas. Awesome. Yep, no problem, Monique. Yep, I will definitely continue the online classes. Speaking of which, Monique, did you email me on Gmail? Because I still haven't received your email. I've been looking for it. I don't know what happened there. But I have contacted you on Etsy. Hey Troy, 140 likes. Oh wow, awesome! We have 140 likes. Oh thanks, Troy. Hey Danielle, What you got planned for Halloween? I will be here. I will be streaming. Halloween is a Saturday, so if you find yourself at home, not going out trick-or-treating or anything like that because, pandemic, I will be here for you. And I really hope that there's internet. The only thing that can really stop me from streaming, other than life events, is the internet. Hey Danielle, you can get mods for. Yeah, I did have a moderator. My buddy Dondo. I don't know where he is, but I'm sure he has stuff to do. Hey Monique. Actually Monique, can you write me your Gmail on Etsy? I think it'd be the easiest. I don't know what's going on with Gmail. Because I was looking through my messages, it did not show up. But at least we have Etsy. Hey Brandy, are you going to paint with a layer of color over this? Yep, that should be Wednesday's video. Definitely. I'm definitely going to go over this with a layer of color. Speaking of which, when. Oh, thank you for favoriting my shop. Speaking of which, everyone that's here right now, everyone that's still with us, since I'm going to be doing the color layer for this one, last time I was talking about mediums. So, is there anything in particular you want me to talk about on Wednesday when we introduce the color layer onto this? Hey, AWS. I'm watching you from Jordan. Awesome. Thank you for watching. Thanks for watching from Jordan. Shout out with the moving brush to you. Thank you. It's right. Hypothetical, say you went too dark in the light, or sorry, too dark on the dark value at this stage. Is there anything you can do to correct that? So Troy, excellent question. At this point, it's impossible for me to go too dark in the darks, and that is just because this doesn't get as dark as this, even though it looks almost the same. If I adjust my lighting for you, see how they look almost the same? The raw umber and the ivory black, but they're not. Raw umber just won't get as dark. So it compresses the value range. It also ensures that nothing ends up too dark, as you meant, Troy. But if somehow, Troy, if I did go too dark somewhere, then I would have to work opaque. So for instance, I may actually end up going too dark here. But if I go too dark, Troy, next time I will just work more opaque to lighten. So when you're layering, as I said, please, if you have any suggestions for what to focus on Wednesday when I introduce color here, there we go, Monique. Got it, got it, got it, got it. I got the Gmail. I wonder what that was before, but I got you. Speaking of which, Monique, I actually started creating the box today for your painting. But Monique, I will give it a little bit longer to be completely touch dry, the painting from before, before applying the Gamvar picture gloss varnish. And then after that, it will take at least 2 days to be ready to ship. Let's see. Hey, Alberto. Brushes technique and blending would be interesting. Oh, blending. Okay. So blending is usually a term that artists tend to shy away from, but if it's more understandable to refer to softening edges and value transitions as blending, then I can talk about that. Just different terminologies. So let me take a look here. Hey, Daniel, are you doing Vlogmas this year? Oh, well, definitely. Now that we're doing these live sessions, definitely each holiday I'll be doing something. Hey, Irwin, how long does it need to cure before you do a color layer? With this, actually, 24 hours, it will be good for a color layer. Hey, Reach 3D Printers, how, let's see, and how the skylight color, purple, bluish, how it interacts with skin tone, and why the local colors are what they are based on those lights intermixing. Yeah, I can definitely talk about that. Next time we will be introducing that. Yep, no worries, Monique. I will make sure it is good to go. When, by the way, everyone wondering about how one sends paintings, I create my own boxes. What I do is I buy bigger boxes and I trim them down and I secure the box with styrofoam and I also test it. So I put a blank canvas or a blank panel in the box and I throw it. I actually throw the box. Not with the painting in it, but with a blank canvas in it to test the box, because we know how things go in the post office. In the past, I used to actually use wood, but I found that styrofoam is much more absorbent of impacts. Hey, Daniel, can you do clouds and talk about perspective paint? I did actually paint clouds, and let's see if it's still here. So again, here's the shop. If you're looking at the image for the shop, I can't fit my hand here. So if you look at the painting to the far left, again, this painting has been sold, this one, but all the other ones are still available. If you're looking at the landscape to the far left, top left, we actually painted clouds in that one. If you look at the second to the last painting on the left, we actually did paint clouds in that one. I think that one was titled Distant Mountains or something like that. But yeah, we've done that and we can always do that again. Hey, Monique. Yeah, I definitely do tests with it. I actually put like equilateral supports on the box to absorb impact from all dimensions, or like all six faces. Hey, Teek, I also run an Etsy shop and the old ADAGE is if you can safely throw the package down the stairs, you're safe. Oh, that's true. I didn't know that was a thing. I just randomly came up with that on my own. I decided to make my boxes and then throw them and make sure that the contents inside the box remain unscathed. I didn't know that was actually a thing, though. Like I said, in the past, I would use wood. Wood to support the boxes. Then I found that it doesn't absorb impact as well. It's non-static collision physics, I think. Non-static collisions from... see, it's been so long since I took physics, which is kind of sad because I would tutor physics students. Kinematic equations and non-static collisions. Non-static means when something collides with something, it collides but doesn't stick, which is why cars, like the engineers for cars, use the materials that they use, because when a car crashes into something, it actually absorbs the impact, whereas if it was rigid and bounced, it would cause us more harm than if the car crashing into something else absorbs some of the impact. So it is some physics applied to it. Yeah, definitely styrofoam does help way more than wood. Hey, I'm Kutch. Oh, I'm glad the raw umber looks good. Hey, Erwin, do you scumble lights when you do a color layer or just glaze transparent colors? I actually build through transparencies, but I do work opaque sometimes, so it's a mix, really. It's not one or the other, it's usually a mix. But glazing usually happens at the end. Hey Gabby, only 2 hours? That would take some artists months. Oh, thank you. I'm wondering, I think I made this hat too big, but oh well. It kind of goes with the composition. Hey Alberto, your artistic nude paintings, are those not allowed on streaming or on Etsy? Yeah, unfortunately, Alberto, they're not. And the crazy thing is, I'm still painting them, but I'm not showing them at all. I'm not even showing them on Instagram, because Instagram would give me problems, especially in the comments. So I'm painting them, but no one really sees them. I'm more just painting them on my own. But yeah, they're definitely not Alberto. Yeah, just some advice. Those kind of paintings are good for learning anatomy. They're good for learning the human form, but they're not well tolerated on the internet. No, Danielle, they don't report me on Instagram, but I would get some really weird comments on there, which I wouldn't want, and I'd end up having to delete them. And I just got tired of deleting so many unwanted comments on my Instagram that I just stopped posting figure paintings altogether. I still do them, but I don't post them. Hey Teek, Really, Instagram surprising considering some of the stuff I see on Instagram. It's true, yeah. Yeah, with Instagram even. It wasn't the case when I first started Instagram. It wasn't the case. But then it just ended up becoming that. Yeah, it is sad, but it's all right, Erwin. As everything in life, we adapt. I honestly, I don't have a problem with what I'm doing with what I'm painting because I find this to be more of my art than anything. These interactions and the final paintings that result from these virtual painting sessions to me are more meaningful than any painting that I can create in silence. Because where and when in history have paintings been created virtually from beginning to end, carrying a dialogue along with everyone and interacting with everyone, learning from everyone? To me, that's what makes this a much more meaningful end result with these paintings. Now, obviously, I'm not the only one painting live streams and talking. I know that, but I just feel like these have so much more. I don't know. Just there's so much more to them. Hey Niba, how do you do this? Oh, thank you. I use OBS, Open Broadcasting Software, connected to YouTube, and I use a little bit of computer code for that, for the chat. Hey Monique, yeah, I'm amazed that just 10 years ago, I wouldn't have known that this, I wouldn't have even fathomed this a possibility. But thanks to technology, there's just so much available to us now. And I really do want to follow in the footsteps of Bob Ross and Bill Alexander when it comes to combining painting and video and turning the combination of those arts or of these arts into its own art. And I still have a long way. We're just getting started. Something Nelson Shanks would always say, we're just getting started. Let's see. Hey, Astro Betasaurus. Hello. Oh, thank you, Niba, for your comment about the talent comment. Thank you. Hey, Alberto. I'm glad that you like this format. Not everyone likes this format, and they usually don't say it in the comments or anything. They just email me directly telling me how much they hate the live stream. So if you do like these live streams, please let me know. And if you haven't left a like and you do like the live streams, please leave a like. It really helps out. Hey, Alberto, oh, thank you. Yeah, definitely. Bob Ross is awesome. Hey Troy, would it be okay if I send you questions in advance for the live stream classes? I'm not sure. Yeah, you can. As I always say, I check my Patreon messages for the online student messages very, very frequently. And though it takes me a while to respond, I definitely do pay a lot of attention to those messages. As I always say, I'm like a hawk. I'm always looking for the messages. But yes, you can definitely send me. Hey, Julia C. You should do a study of a painting with oil paints made by you, mixing pigments and stuff, if you can, obviously, because that requires a lot of work. You mean a study of my own paintings? I'm sorry. I'm a little slow at reading that. Hey, Mikael, him J.I. I'm doing an underpainting too. Awesome. Hey, Daniel. Yeah, they do. Whenever I put my email there, for everyone to send me their, if they want a free sample lesson, sometimes I get some hate mail in there. It's hilarious. Hey, Karam. Oh, thank you. Nebo, this is 11 by 14 inch. Astro Beta Cyrus, oh thank you. Hey, I'm Kutch. Oh, I'm glad you like the format. I'm glad it has that kind of educational feel to it. But as I always say, I mean, you know what I always say. These are virtual painting sessions. All right, so I was just reading the comments for a little while. Now I'm gonna go back to the painting itself. So I think that I may have too much out here, and I have this shape a little too sharp. Remember, in the underpaintings, it's very advisable to work light because it's easier to layer darker over lighter when you're layering onto a dry painting. And I'm going to say that again next time. And you'll see exactly what I mean when we layer over this on Wednesday. And also, this painting will be available for purchase on the last day it's streamed. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it for sale right before the stream starts to give everyone a chance that's been watching this live to own this painting that they're watching, be created. But it's a first come, first serve basis. So you have to be a little quick. Hey Monique, I like this format too. Like you said, it's virtual painting. It's not a formal lesson, but it's more like a discussion and demo to take place, ask questions and pick up tips. Yeah, definitely. And I learned from the audience too. I learned things that I didn't even know about. Like I wouldn't have known about without doing this. Hey, Julia C, do you speak any other language? I watched a video of yours saying something about, no, English is my language. No, sometimes I say that I butcher my English, meaning I, sometimes, when your native language is, whichever your native language is, sometimes when you're speaking and you're doing something at the same time, you tend to misspeak. English is my first language. It's just sometimes I misspeak. But I can speak Spanish, a little bit of Spanish, like a teeny, teeny, tiny bit of Spanish. Hey Troy, man, painting is so hard, and you make it look effortless. Oh, thank you. There's a lot of effort that goes into making something look effortless, though. I mean, this is definitely taking a lot of thinking. You know what I hope to have one day? Among other things, I really hope to have my name, Yupari, on brushes one day. I don't know, maybe I can do something with Vistaprint and then sell them, but that would be so cool. Another dream of mine has been to be able to travel the world and film, painting and traveling the world, painting the world, and, doing these kind of virtual painting sessions, but in like a Netflix style, something like that. As I always do and somehow forgot to do today, please check out the link to my online class. Again, remember the online classes are $10 a month. You get 3 lessons a week, a behind-the-scenes video every week, and a virtual classroom every week, giving you a total of 5 videos for $10 a month, including the ability to send me images each week for the virtual classroom. Again, the link to my Patreon is right here. If you type out patreon.com/YupariArtist, at the moment, YouTube is blocking my link to my online class, which is sad. But at least you can see it here. I tried to post it here, but YouTube blocked me from it, which it does a lot now. So if you don't mind, please type patreon.com/YupariArtist and check out the online class/mentor tier. I'm really sad that YouTube is blocking my Patreon link. But I guess YouTube does what it does. Hey, I'm Kuchia. That's a dream of mine. Hey, Alberto. I do that travel the world, but with photography. What? That's awesome. But would like to do it also with painting. Painting my models. Yeah. Also, new students. So new students, I send you the welcoming package as soon as I am notified and at the computer. I send you a welcoming package with the links to all of the videos. So the videos for the online classes are organized in playlists. So for example, say suppose project two, right? For example, there's a link to a playlist for Project 2 containing each one of the videos in chronological order so you can watch the lessons at your own pace and work on the lessons at your own pace. Take care, Artifex Mom. Thanks for joining. Oh, I missed a comment. Hey, Prudence. Hello. I'm saying hello back. Now I'm really gonna kick up the light right here. So I'm painting that area really thick, but I'm gonna flatten out the light a little bit. Hey Julia, sorry if I mispronounced your name. Do you think it's possible to paint a portrait with a Zorn palette or any other primary colors and having a great result? Zorn palette plus raw umber is a really good palette. The reason I say that is because raw umber, just like burnt umber, is what you want for underpaintings, because it, again, it compresses the value range, it dries fast, and it lends itself really nice to layering skin tones over them. So for portrait, it's a really nice palette to have if you have the Zorn palette plus raw umber. If you have the Zorn palette plus raw umber, you're set. You almost don't really need any more colors at all for portraiture. Hey Mikhail, K-Him-J-I. Do you always make the underpaintings this detailed? I'm surprised that you find this detailed. For me, this is not very detailed, but my underpaintings are usually somewhat like this. Sometimes I put more, sometimes I put less. This is still very early. You know, there's still so much more to describe here. So much to say that hasn't been said, but I'm glad that you find this to be already very detailed. Let's see. Hey Martin, for you too. Is she? Okay, that's a good question. Since this is Unsplash, a copyright-free resource, I don't quite know who the model was. So if you do know who it is, or in Unsplash, it didn't really say, but there is a chance you may know who the model is. Hey Niba, is there something you do all the time or do sometimes? Something I do all the time is this, actually. I'm getting a dry brush, clean and dry synthetic, and softening edges. To me, edges are a huge, huge part of the painting process that oftentimes goes unnoticed. Edges. So I'm very cautious with the edges here. And I pretty much do that in every layer, beginning to end. Hey, I'm Coach. Naples Yellow Light is something I have been using for highlights. It has been working great. Awesome. You know what I want to get is lead tin yellow. And maybe for the holidays I'll purchase it for myself, but lead tin yellow is something I've been wanting to get. Hey, who, Maria Loya? Oh, thank you. Oh, you mean streaming. yeah, I do stream now for the most part. It seems that everyone likes it, except for the ones that send me the hate mail, but it seems like everyone likes it for the most part. And you can scroll through the video and you can kind of create your own time lapse of it too. But I just love being able to connect with everyone. I think that adds so much to this. Hey Regina, hello. But in terms of when I stream, I usually stream Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. Sometimes I have to miss a stream or two, but usually Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. Around 5 or 5:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. For example, I will very likely be back working on this again Wednesday around 5 or 5:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Hey Paolo, oh, thanks for the hello from Portugal. Oh, thanks, Regina. So I was asking everyone earlier, since I'm gonna be back here on su or no, on Wednesday, and I'm gonna introduce the first color on this. I'm asking everyone what you would like me to talk about, as a as kind of like a subtopic. So last time I was talking about mediums, right? So what would you like me to talk about on Wednesday? We still have a little while to go on this today, but for Wednesday, do you want me to talk about brushes? I got a question about brushes. Do you want me to talk about specific colors? I don't know, Zorn palette? I don't know. What would you like me to talk about? And this is another thing I really like about this, is that I can ask you directly. Hey, I'm Coach. I appreciate your streams. I get some painting time in with you. I'll share my projects on Patreon. Yeah, I'd love to see them, and thank you. Hey, Julia C. I'm Brazilian, and I speak English, and your channel is one of the things that makes me most happy for having studied English. Oh, thank you. That's so sweet. That's so sweet of you, Julia. And since, let's see, makes me most happy for having studied English since I was young, so now I can understand and study by your content. Thank you. That was so sweet. Hey, Monique, turning the form. So about form, yeah, I can definitely emphasize the form next time. Hey, Niba, I use a digital drawing app for my virtual classroom. I use it to draw the suggestions that I make for my online students on their images that they send me. But I haven't. I've used digital drawing for compositions to plan out, help me plan out compositions, but I haven't taken a digital drawing or painting to it a full completion yet. Hey Mark, Zorn palette and brushes. Yep, that can work. Oh yeah, no worries about the spelling. I got you. So suggestions we have are form and Zorn palette. You know, technically I can title these videos the same thing each time, like I kind of did with this one. And the what I talk about while I'm painting can be content that you ask me yourself. So again, that's why I really like these streams, because what you ask me, when you're asking me things while I'm painting, it gives me the opportunity to know what everyone's thinking. Because creating a video by myself, titling it on my own, I'm kind of guessing what everyone wants to see. It takes a long time, it takes forever to read comments on previous videos and then try to ascertain from that some type of subject matter that everyone wants to watch. Whereas doing this live, you can send me your questions and I can talk about your questions live. And to me, it's just so much more efficient to do it this way. Hey, someone saying, again, I really like your username. You should try out Art Rage if you haven't. Art Rage. I gotta look that one up, but thank you for the suggestion. I'll check it out. Sorry, I'm kind of losing my voice. I have a water bottle. Hey, Neva. You're the first streamer to have ever responded to a comment I've written. I am so happy. Well, thank you. I mean, I'm touched that I can provide you joy. Of course, feel free to ask me any questions here, art related. Or, questions that are suitable for YouTube. Always make sure to stay hydrated, everyone. Right now, what I'm trying to do with this, as you notice, I've been kind of fiddling with this edge, is I don't want it to be kind of like a super long line, like the Joker, like a line like the Joker. So I'm kind of softening it and adjusting it and tweaking it. Hey, Realistic Art. Hello. Thanks for watching from India. Oh, this was a clean, dry brush. Hey Alberto, why Etsy and not Saatchi Art? I see lots of well-known painters there. To be honest, I haven't heard of that one, the one that you've sent me. That's the real reason. But I can look into it. As again, I'm trying to be honest and transparent. There's just things I don't know about. So, you writing this and everyone writing to me, you're teaching me as well. I heard one artist say that you're always painting for the next day. I think that was like Cesar Santos or somebody said that in some YouTube video or some, I forgot. I heard it from some artist. You're always painting for the next day. So I'm just trying to put something down here that I can build onto. In essence, really. Hey, Mark, did you check out Edwin? No, I apologize. I'm gonna screenshot that though. If this was a suggestion that I missed before, I'm gonna take a screenshot of your comment there. Edwin Holgate Portraits. All right, I have taken a screenshot, and I will check that out. Or check the artist out, sorry. Hey Monique, there are many good places to sell your art. Daily Paint Works is another online site. All right, screenshot your comment there, Monique, also. I'm taking a bunch of screenshots so I can read this later. And one thing I always look out for, I was looking out for it here, but I forgot to mention it, is 90-degree angles. So anything that's super sharp, like a 90-degree angle, I usually round the edge of it, just for the sake of aesthetics. And this actually reminds me of a composition that I painted a long time ago. That video was titled Portrait Painting Tutorial. I think it was like the first one I titled Classical Approach. I remember that one because when that one sold, I actually delivered it myself because the buyer was like 10 minutes, lived like 10 or 20 minutes away. All right, so any art questions? This is the time, the best time to ask. As we're approaching a close now with this. But I still want to put something down here for the element of jewelry. So remember that thin paint tends to stick onto thick paint. So that's an Alla Prima trick. I added a little bit of Gamsol to this. Though you can't see it, I'm going to make it up. Hold on. Wait a second. I'm actually going to raise the shirt a little bit more. As I said, I am editing this, not painting it as I see it. Alrighty, the comments are coming in. Let's see. Hey Monique, looking forward to watching you paint the hair. Yeah, definitely, the hair will be fun to paint. Mikhail, have you ever used a proportional divider? I can't say I have or recall having used one, but I do have a caliper that I use to measure from time to time. Am Kutch, go. It's Zumba time. See you next time. Well, I hope you'll enjoy the Zumba. Sounds like fun. Maybe we can share some photos to you to paint. I'm a photographer. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, on the Gmail, definitely. Hey, Neba, you should see Pop Cross Studios Art and ZHC. All right, Neba, taking a screenshot of your comment as well. Thank you so much, Neba. I have taken a screenshot. Hey, Prina, let's see, Leonardo da Vinci drawing. Good. Look into that. Hey Teek, logging off to work on my fundamentals portrait. Thanks for the stream. Well, thanks for joining in. And again, we're approaching a close with the underpainting. I just want to make sure that I get the element of jewelry in here. So I'm lifting this because there's not enough clearance there yet. That should be enough clearance there. And remember, not using any medium. Yep, take care, Neba. Oh, wait. I think that was addressed to Teak. Whoops. Now, I'm trying to be a little cautious with the raw umber. If I paint the raw umber too thick, the raw umber can actually take longer now than the light to dry, since I didn't put any alkyd in the raw umber. Even though raw umber is a quick dryer, if a pigment is very fast drying or whatever, if you paint too thick, then it'll still take a long time to dry. So I'm kind of spreading the paint across. Hey, Regina. Oh, thank you. Well, thanks, Monique. I just had to cover the bottom there before I forgot. Hey, Julia, I'm going to paint my first portrait ever. I'll be using acrylics. Do you have any tips? Definitely. With acrylics, I would highly suggest... I'm going to type it out for you, Julia. I would highly suggest you use a Stay Wet palette. And it's actually titled STA instead of STAY. So Stay Wet palette for acrylic. It's the one with the sponge. What you can also do, so the Stay Wet palette, this is my suggestion for painting with acrylic. What you can do also, if you can't find the Stay Wet palette, is buy parchment paper for your palette. Get a dinner plate. Put a wet paper towel, piece of wet paper towel on top of the dinner plate. And then put wet parchment paper over top of the paper towel. And that will actually kind of create a very quick Stay Wet palette. That's actually what I did yesterday. When I was painting the pumpkin. What it does is it helps to keep your paints from drying too quickly on the palette. Because if you paint acrylic, if you mix acrylic paint onto a dry palette, your acrylic paint will end up drying much faster, and then you'll end up not using all of your acrylic. Hey Anna, Carolina, are you going to live the finish of this painting? If yes, do you already have a plan of when? I really would like to see it. Coincidentally, this painting should be completed on Saturday, but Saturday is Halloween, so I gotta think that through a little bit, because this is gonna take me 3 streams to complete. So next time I'm going to introduce the color, and then the third stream will be the completion of this painting, which in theory should be on Saturday. But as I mentioned earlier, I'm going to make this painting available for purchase right before I start the stream to give everyone watching live the advantage or the opportunity to purchase this painting first. As these are first come, first serve. So if you are interested in purchasing this painting in the future, the day that it should be completed is actually around Halloween, October 31st. Yep. No problem, Julia. Hey, Sarah. Oh, I'm glad that you enjoy watching the videos. All right. So I was going to paint the element of jewelry there. And of course, I'm going to edit it. I think I placed it incorrectly. There. Yes, I know. I know. I'm not following the photo reference that much. But again, remember, painting, at least in my opinion, I enjoy interpreting visual information and creating a painting. Not so much, copying. Hey, Barbara, she is fun to paint. Your classes are well worth the charge and the time. Oh, thank you. Hey, Mark. I can definitely send you a free sample lesson. Again, just send me an email at my Gmail. I'm going to type it out again for you. So, again, anyone else that is interested in joining the online classes but don't know if they're right for you, I can definitely send you a free sample lesson. It's usually the ending of Project One. So here is my Gmail. I just have to make sure I spelled my name right. All right, there it is. Hey B, Betty. Hi, you probably looks awesome. I'm hoping to start your classes soon. Do you have a sample that I can see? Definitely, I do. So everyone that would like to have a sample, a free sample lesson, I usually send the ending of Project One. Please send me an email to my Gmail. It's just my name, and then followed by theartist@gmail. I know I should have titled that something else, but that's just what I titled it. But anyway, if you'd like a free sample lesson, definitely send me an email. Hey, Astro Beta Cyrus, what can I use instead of raw umber? I can't find it anymore. You can use burnt umber. If you can't find burnt umber or raw umber, you can use an alkyd, even though it will dry with the quickness. You can use an alkyd. This is not a good example because this is titanium white, but you can use any of the dark colors. The alkyd version, but if you can't find raw umber, definitely burnt umber if that one is more easily accessible. You know, even the jewelry is being edited. Even the connection of the jewelry here, I'm changing it. I'm changing it to fit the composition. Hey, Mark. Just sent you an email. Awesome. Yeah, I will get back to you. Hey, Astro Beta Cyrus. Yeah, burnt umber is perfectly fine. Yeah, you can use burnt umber too. All right, so I think that about covers it. What I'm gonna do now is just run the fan brush across it just to eliminate any excess paint buildup and soften edges. The nice thing is the paint started to tack up already, which is good. So I know that this will be dry and ready to go by Wednesday evening. Let's see. Hey, Luella, do you have any opinions on varnish on top of oil paintings, matte or glossy? I typically use gloss. So for instance, the painting that was just purchased today, this has a gloss finish, So I tend to use Gamvar, picture varnish gloss. I just really like the gloss. Like the gloss look is very official, and I don't know. I mean, I just like the and also I stretched this one by myself. So if you're watching, and you purchased this painting today, you're gonna definitely have a really nice solid background. So I actually created the stretcher as well. So I created the stretcher and stretched it and primed and did everything for this painting. So I'm so glad this one is going to its forever home. But yeah, I really like this varnish, Gamvar gloss picture varnish. Hey Cynthia, how often are you painting from live models nowadays? I am my only live model that I'm painting from nowadays, and I'd say about once every 2 weeks I'm working on a different self-portrait. Not as much as I should, but I try to keep doing self-portraits. Hey Luella, I've been considering using a varnish on top of my paintings. Oh, I'm glad that this helps. Hey Mark, I'm glad you like the changes. How do I calculate my prices for my paintings? I usually standardize them really. In particular, the paintings that are created here are the ones that will be for sale. What I do, some would consider it kind of a overly radical, but some of the paintings that I know I'm not going to sell, I pretty much end up destroying the ones that I know I'm going to sell. Or what I do is I paint over them. So I'm very keen on which paintings I sell and which paintings what I do with the paintings. But I do try to, for instance, this series of paintings, the virtual painting sessions. I love this because when these paintings are purchased, the buyer can watch the entire painting as it's created, because these YouTube videos will be available. They can show their fellow collectors and friends and family, like, look how this painting was created. And also, I mean, it's a series of paintings, so they're all grouped together with the same price. Hey, Irwin. Yeah, the gloss varnish does bring out the colors nicely. Cynthia, yeah, from a mirror. Yeah, I do self-portraits from a mirror. All right, so that should be about good for that. I noticed I didn't cover all the way down her arm. I think it would just be easier for me next time if I cover all the way down. So we're almost there. Now what I'm gonna do is put the brush down. This should be good to let dry for next time. Notice how light this is and how soft the edges are. That's a very important thing to have to build over top of. Hey Julia, what about skin tone mixing? I'm really not an expert. So definitely, if you're interested in skin tones, on Wednesday, we're going to get into that, the skin tones in particular. So Wednesday around the same time, so around 5 or 5:30 Eastern Standard Time, we will be back and putting in the skin tone layer. So yeah, now this is going to be our dedicated questions and answers as I clean my brushes. So I'm going to start to clean my brushes, and then I'm going to clean the palette. I'm going to hang out for a little bit and answer questions. Now my attention is going to be completely focused on the comments. So, hey, Rasha, what is the medium you use? Okay, the medium, I'm not using any medium right now. So in the early layers of a oil painting that you are going to, well, basically in the early layers of any painting, it's important not to use too much medium. You can, but not too much. I didn't use any, so I just use Gamsol or just odorless mineral spirits to thin out the paint for the background and the areas that are more thin, but no medium yet. We'll use medium on Wednesday. But thank you for your question. And I just used the Gamsol and paper towel to clean these brushes. And again, right under here, I have my container with my solvent and the paper towel. Hey, Rasha. Yep, just solvent. You're right. I do usually use turpentine, but I ran out. I'm using Gamsol. Turpentine actually does a better job, in my opinion, of cleaning and thinning the paint. I have to be a little more careful with Gamsol than turpentine. I usually use distilled turpentine. Edward, fun random question. If you could do a painting from start to finish but could only use one brush, what would it be? That is a very creative question. If I could only do one painting from start to finish and only use one brush, I think it would be... that depends on the brush, too. I think I would paint a mango because I like mangoes and they're somewhat round, so I can get away with using one brush. I would probably just use one large round brush. Very creative question. Hey, Astro Beta Cyrus, can we just use the oil paint alone without any medium? You can. You certainly can, but I would recommend to use medium in the later layers. And I always recommend this one as my preferred medium for everyone to use. Neo Megilp by the brand Gamblin. This is the medium I always recommend everyone because it's easily accessible. It is a fast dryer, but it's not ultra fast drying, and it doesn't have too much of an odor, so it's a really nice medium to use. No problem, Rasha. Hey, Erwin, do you do anything to shape the brushes after you clean it? As you can tell, I probably should. But no, I just used the solvent. However, with the Princeton Catalyst Polytip Bristle Brushes, these, my favorite brushes, I clean it with solvent, and then afterwards I clean it with hot water and dish soap. Hey, Enigma. Okay. Sure, buddy. I think I remember your comments from before. See ya. All right, let's see. Hey, Astro Beta Cyrus. So yeah, I'm just cleaning the brushes with the solvent, and then after this I'm going to clean them with hot water and hot water and dish soap. And now I'm going to clean the brushes. Or not the brushes, the palette. Oh, no worries, Mark. Yeah, they're gone. They're gone. What the heck is going on with YouTube? Yep, you've been reported. Ooh, you made a boo-boo. You are gone. Let's see. Edward Soto, I really like your style of painting. You're planning on doing another landscape painting? Yeah, definitely. We'll definitely do more landscapes in the future and still life. Just right now, we've kind of returned to the portraits. Let's see. Hey, Cincy, do you leave your brushes soaked in linseed? I've heard that some artists do this. I guess it's okay if you paint a lot. I don't, just because then I have a brush that's full of linseed oil the next time, so I don't really do that. Though I'm sure you could if you were working on a painting for multiple layers and you don't mind the extra linseed oil on the brush. And you've already been reported and kicked out. Oh, I accidentally hit the undo. That's funny. I'm not going to undo that one this time. And there we go. Palette is all nice and clean. So I'll hang out for a little bit longer and wait for any questions. Yep, no problem, Cincy. Oh, hey, Monique. Have you done the exercise that Richard Schmid suggests of the color charts? I have made color charts in the past. And on the YouTube channel, there are actually color charts here. I don't know if it's exactly how Richard Schmid suggests, but I have made color charts before. Thanks for pointing that out, Monique. I should probably look up Richard Schmid's. Hey, Rasha, when the first layer dries, let's see. So when this dries, I usually will use a little bit of a fatter combination of paint, meaning just like a little more oil content. That's what fat over lean means. So this should be the leanest layer, so it has no medium. Hey, Steven, welcome to the stream. Thank you. Hey, Alex. Oh, no worries. No worries there. We'll definitely be back on Wednesday. This was definitely a wild, wild stream, but a lot of fun. Let's see. I apologize. Let's see. Raimundo Notando Castello Junior Castello, Qué Técnicas. I can understand what you wrote, but I can't understand the question. I apologize, buddy. Hey, Erwin, have you had any trouble establishing a brand since you paint different subjects? People seem to ignore my still life or landscape because I paint figures. Kind of, yeah. I have that issue when I paint anything other than portrait, yeah. Yeah, I know what you mean. Hey, Alex. Oh, no worries, buddy. Yep, thanks again, Monique, and I'll be contacting you on Etsy and Gmail. Hey, Alex. Yeah, we're definitely gonna be heading out soon. But everyone that's watching, I just noticed we have 191 likes. So if we get 9 more likes, we'll have 200 likes. So everyone watching that likes the stream that hasn't left a like, do me a favor and hit the like button or the thumbs up. And I'll just sit and hang out and answer some questions. And by the way, thanks, Astro Beta Cyrus. I'm glad you like the painting. Yep, this is the underpainting. And again, by the way, I have written out my Gmail, so if anyone is interested in the online classes for $10 a month and doesn't know if the classes are right for them, and would like a free sample lesson, please feel free to contact me and I can send you a sample lesson. Which, by the way, I notice I have to correct her nose. I'm gonna fix this angle next time. So just 2 more likes and we get to 200 likes. So just 2. Anyone out there? All we need is 2 more likes as I'm sitting here and answering questions. All right, so just one more. Oh, by the way, I really like these cups. I think I also put this, hopefully I put this in the materials list in the description, but the nice thing is that you can close them and they're kind of like really airtight. It's a nice feature of these. Oh yay, we hit 200. What's up? What's up? Thank you so much to everyone that has viewed this stream, written a comment, and left a like. Thank you so much, everyone. I'm so happy to have 200 likes. I'm also very happy that this painting has now found a forever home. So this was the special for today. So this painting was purchased during the stream, which, by the way, I will have specials during the live streams for anyone that is interested in purchasing an original oil painting, along with a bonus mystery oil painting study on a sheet of cotton canvas. So here is the painting that I will be creating the box for and sending to the Forever Home later on this week. Paintings ship within about 1 to 2 weeks. And also, during the special, you get a surprise painting on a sheet of cotton canvas. Now, it's not necessarily going to be this one, though someone can get this one. It's going to be randomized, so you won't actually know which one it is till you receive it, but you will have a painting like this one, a painting study in the box containing the painting that you purchase as part of the special for those of you that would like to buy paintings during the live streams. Let's see. Oh, thank you, Bert 2008 before 69. Thanks, Astro Beta Cyrus, for hitting the like button. And wow, we're at 205. So thank you so much, everyone. This is such an amazing experience. And yeah, that's gonna be about it for tonight. So thank you so much, everyone, for joining. Remember, the way this goes is that we will very, very likely be back on Wednesday around the same time, 5 or 5:30 Eastern Standard Time. So around 5 or 5:30. It all really depends on how my schedule is going on that day. Eastern Standard Time. I wish you the very best. Hold on. I just got a question. oh, thank you. Do you stretch your own canvases? Yes. Yes, I do. I stretch my own canvases. Hey, Neldia. What technique this is? Oh, okay. Thank you for pointing that out right before I almost left. Thank goodness. Thank you for pointing that out. This is a kind of a mix between the classical and alla prima approach, meaning this is classical approach with an alla prima start. So this would have been full classical approach had I done a transfer drawing and worked through washes of dark layers. Instead, I used alla prima to move a little bit faster. I teach through the classical approach, however, but I use this as my main technique for painting. Oh, thank you so much, Kathy, Stephen, Neldia. Yep, no worries. Thanks for pointing that out. And again, I apologize to everyone of whom I've missed or may have missed your comments. So again, thank you so much, everyone, for watching. I wish you the very best in all of your artwork. And I will see you on the next one.